Hello, in this video, we're going to show C phrase compared to OpenAI, their natural language processor. So here we just see C phrase doing a query here over the cities located in California. And then what we're going to do here is we're going to go over here and we're going to submit that to OpenAI. And it didn't take long at all. And this is the actual problem that gets submitted to OpenAI. And what we see here is we see just the here's the actual SQL that gets generated or returned back. So that worked. And then let's go up and let's see kind of some other stuff, some other possibilities here. So we might have something like, say, like, give me the largest state, all right? So now C phrase deals with ambiguity. So C phrase is using semantically tractable set to solve its problems. So it's a quite a bit different technique. So in this case, though, it gets it right. So, but it's not ambiguous. It decides population is what largest is based on. So that came through without any extra work. So now if we look right here, let's look at something like this, like the smallest city in the largest state. Okay, so this is ambiguous in the sense that we could have the smallest, the different types of. So in this case here, it's the smallest populations, cities in the largest density states. But let's give this to OpenAI and let's see actually if it can work, if it can do it. And actually, very, very interestingly, it's able to actually generate one of the meanings. So this is with zero configuration, so it's actually able to go in to figure that out. So that's pretty impressive, actually. And then let's just go and let's take a look at some other aspects here. So we might want to say something, let's see here, what are we going to do? Well, something like this, like the three tallest mountains on the West Coast. Now, I've actually, the West Coast has been coded here just to be California, Oregon, and Washington. So this is kind of a direct encoding inside the C phrase. But what's interesting here is if we give this to OpenAI, then what we get here, well, let's look at the SQL here, because it's quite interesting. And kind of reminiscence of maybe showing some kind of common sense here. So it's actually going and determining the Pacific Ocean should be bordered. So there's really a lot of potential here, especially if the schema was more complicated to be able to answer questions like that. So so I think it's really promising. So thank you very much for watching, and feel free to use C phrase and call out to OpenAPI.